Hey, what's up, vinyl community? Bill here from the Vinylverse. Thought I'd enter Jeff Kempin's Crazy Eights 100 subs contest. Jeff, congratulations on your 100 subs. I've been watching your channel for some time now. Really enjoy your videos, what you have to say. So I haven't done many videos, but I thought I'd try to enter this contest and give it a whirl. It's the first contest entry I've participated in, so sounded cool, so here I am. Anyway, I tried to think a little outside the box on some of these, be not too obvious. There might be one or two obvious ones in my list, but Crazy Eights. So Jeff's contest was 8 albums from any year ending with an 8. So 1968, 1978, etc. I have albums from 1958, 1968, 1978, and 1988. So let's get started. First one I have, Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers, Moanin'. Really great album, jazz album from 1958. 1958 was a great year for jazz, and this is one of the best ones, in my opinion, that came out that year. Sticking with jazz, John Coltrane, Blue Train. Again, 1958, one of my favorite albums. Unfortunately, I don't have a Blue Note version of this. Maybe someday I'll get a copy, but I got a European pressing on the Dahl label. Now jumping to 1968. The Birds, the Bees, and the Monkees. I don't think the Monkees get a lot of love. I think they're a great band. Early stuff is very poppy, but the further along in their career, it got very interesting. This album is a really good one, in my opinion. Great song. Songs like Tapioca Tundra, Mike Nesmith song, Daydream Believer, Valerie. Just a great album all around. Sticking with 1968, what can you say? Johnny Cash, Folsom Prison. Classic album. Now jumping to 1978, probably my favorite artist, Peter Gabriel. I pretty much love everything he does, he puts out. This is his second solo album. Some people call it Scratch, based on the cover art. It's not one of his top albums, but solid all around. I really enjoy it. Now, 1978, Peter Gabriel's former band, Genesis, and then there were three. This album by Genesis doesn't get a lot of love. Kind of a transition album. I really enjoy it. It's pretty great. Hit off of this one was Follow You, Follow Me. Sticking with 1978, UK. I don't know if you want to call UK a supergroup, but had John Wetton and Bill Bruford after they moved on from King Crimson, along with Alan Holdsworth, a great guitarist, and Eddie Jobson doing some violin, keyboards, electronics, stuff like that. Really good prog fusion album. I don't know really how to classify it, but jazzy, proggy, really good. And now number 8, different from all the rest of the albums that I mentioned, but really love this album. Edie Brickell and the New Bohemians, their first album. Really good all around again, in my opinion. So, that's my eight. Again, Jeff, congratulations. I'm sure your subs are just going to keep going up and up and up with all the videos you're putting out, and I really enjoy them, so keep up the good work, and thanks a lot. Bill from the Vinylverse, signing off. Take care, everyone.